Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter respiration. In that we are studying topic the difference between aerobic and anaerobic respiration. We all know that aerobic respiration uses oxygen and anaerobic is in the absence of oxygen. What are the other differences? Let's study and find out. If I say about aerobic respiration, you all will say that it needs large amount of oxygen or it needs oxygen to take place. Yes. When I talk about anaerobic respiration doesn't need oxygen or it can never take place in the absence of oxygen. It needs absence of oxygen. No oxygen has to be present in anaerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration basically takes place in eukaryotic cells, whereas anaerobic respiration takes place in prokaryotic cells, on bacterial cells or single cellular organism or unicellulars. During anaerobic respiration, there is incomplete oxidation or incomplete breakdown of organic food material, whereas during aerobic respiration, there is complete oxidation or complete breakdown of organic food material. Less energy is released during organic, or you can say less energy in the form of ATP is released during anaerobic respiration, which is approximately 2 ATP, whereas during aerobic respiration, the ATP released is approximately 38. End products are different. In the case of anaerobic, it is ethyl alcohol. In the case of aerobic, it's carbon dioxide and water. What is the difference between aerobic and anaerobic respiration? Now, when we talk about anaerobic respiration, it is a respiration that will take place in the absence of oxygen. Now, anaerobic respiration takes place especially more in prokaryotic cell. When I say prokaryotic cell, it could be a bacterial cell or an amoebial cell, basically in unicellular organisms. There is total no need of oxygen. It can take place in the absence of oxygen. There is incomplete oxidation of food materials. Materials like carbohydrates, proteins, fats are broken down but in incomplete manner. And obviously, if there is incomplete oxidation of food materials, less ATP would be synthesized, and which is approximately 2 ATP. Now, the end products of this kind of respiration are carbon dioxide and ethyl alcohol. And ethyl alcohol will lead to fermentation, whereas carbon dioxide is used either in some cases or it is removed out of the system. Reaction of glycolysis is in the cytosol when it is anaerobic respiration. The aerobic respiration process takes place in the presence of oxygen. It needs oxygen to carry on, and it basically takes place in the eukaryotic cell. When I say eukaryotic cell, it means human beings, plants, animals for that matter, the bigger multicellular cells. 38 ATP or energy currencies are produced per glucose of aerobic respiration. That's quite huge. And the end products are basically CO2 and water, which could be used in the photosynthesis process in this eukaryotic organisms. Now, glycolysis in this process is in the cytosol, whereas the Krebs cycle is in the mitochondria, that is the ATP's machine where it is situated at that place. This process of aerobic respiration needs ETS or electron transport system to work, and various electron acceptors, which is the protein machinery, whether it is cytochrome C, dehydrogenase, NADP dehydrogenase complexes, have to work together to generate ATP. And finally, free molecular oxygen act as an electron acceptor in this process of aerobic respiration as compared to anaerobic respiration, where it doesn't happen. Oxygen is never the last electron acceptor in the case of aerobic respiration in certain organisms. Whereas in anaerobic respiration, it is always that oxygen is never the last electron acceptor. And in aerobic organism, oxygen has to be the last electron acceptor in most of the cases. Students, in this part of the chapter, what we did try to understand was that what is aerobic respiration and what is anaerobic respiration, and how these two terms are different from one another in terms of organisms and their functioning. I hope students, you are very clear about this concept of aerobic and anaerobic respiration. Thank you.